Yeah, I play a lot of nasty characters. It's what I get cast to do. I kind of look like an asshole, so I get cast as asshole characters. Sometimes I would find myself saying stuff like Bellick would say, having the same kind of negative attitude, getting pissed off at people and stuff. Yeah, I call it character hangover. I don't like having to go into this horrible kind of psyche of a guy like that. He's a horrible person. My father was a monk. He left my mom and the family and became a monk, and we didn't hear from him for about 5 years. Well, we keep in touch, but he's a monk, so you can't really talk to him very much. I started off studying to be a doctor, and I worked at a hospital from the time I was about 18 until I was 26. I used to sing in the choir, so I took some voice lessons at school. The last 2 years of college, I took acting classes and got a degree in acting. I thought, well, I'll go to graduate school. That way, if I can't get a job acting, I can teach. So I went to Rutgers University to graduate school for 3 years. And within 9 months after I got out of graduate school, I was on Broadway in Les Miserables. I was a swing, and swings understudy like 14 different parts. Every time somebody went on vacation in Les Mis, or there was like a epidemic of the flu or some stomach virus on the show, they would call me in because I knew all the parts. You never know why you get a job, and you never know why you don't. It could be you get hired because you remind the director of his wife's brother. It could be you don't get hired because you remind the director of his wife's brother. You gotta be crazy to do this. You gotta have a screw loose. Why not live just an easygoing, calm life like the average bear, you know, and just take what life throws at you and deal with that? No, we've gotta read a play about, you know, our parents dying in a car accident when they're young, and then they grow up and they lose everything in a Great Depression, and then are reborn by some miracle of Deus Ex Machina that, you know, saves them from the fiery pit in the end, and then, you know, you go out to your applause. The best thing about being an actor is you have a lot of time off, and the worst thing about being an actor is you have a lot of time off. They say in New York that you know you're a successful actor when you can claim your unemployment benefits. That means you have to work like 14 weeks. Right. If you can work 14 weeks as an actor, then you get like 26 weeks of unemployment. And for a long time, I would design my lifestyle so that I could live on unemployment. I used to write bad checks for pizza. And I would buy like two or three pizzas and put them in the refrigerator because I didn't have any cash. So I couldn't go to the grocery store. So then I would end up spending half of my next check paying off the $20 check for the pizza plus the $20 return check fee because it bounced. So I was in bad shape then. That kind of lifestyle doesn't lend itself to having a girlfriend, much less a family. I had a dog, though, with me for all those years. I had a big white Samoyed named Sam. He was like 100 pounds. He went everywhere with me. Well, I was here in L.A. trying to, you know, do film and television. And I already bought a house by then, and met my wife. She came to rent a room in my house, but it was too expensive for her, so she turned it down. But we ended up going to a party and hooking up anyway. Now she stays for free. I worked with this one producer, and he used to tell young actors when they would ask him, they would say, "What's the most important thing for a young actor to have?" And he would say, "Rich parents." I like to read. I play a lot of musical instruments. From blue to gray to green, the prettiest eyes I've seen. I didn't get any auditions for about 6 months. And I was on unemployment. I had a house, a brand new baby girl. She was only like 6 or 9 months old, and I totally flipped out at that point. How many people in the country have a budget where they don't have to work for 6 months? Most of us have never made that kind of money before. I never made that kind of money before I got on prison break. And I didn't even make a lot of money on prison break comparatively. I'm not a, you know, handsome guy, and I'm not a, you know, I don't have, I'm a journeyman actor, I'm a character guy. And, you know, probably I'm never gonna, you know, have a big movie career or, you know, get the lead on some big TV show. It's just not who I am. I have a great family life, and a lot of time to myself to do whatever I want and be with my family, and then I get to work every once in a while.